Hi guys, in today's video we are going to create a load more button with a fade in effect using JavaScript. Let's start. If you take a look in the browser, you see that I have some items displayed. Actually, those items are books. Beneath the books, I have a load more button. When I click on the load more button, more content will display it on the page. Let's see this. Every time I click on the load more button, more content is added. And when there is no more content left to display, the load more button is hidden. Now, how much content is displayed in the page is controlled by the JavaScript file that is loaded behind the browser. In the JavaScript file, I have a variable called initial items, and it controls how many items are displayed when the page first loads. The current value is set to 3. Next, I have a variable called load items and controls how many items are loaded when the load more button is pressed. Its value is also set to 3. You can set any value you like. The script is going to work just fine. Let's change those values and check it out. Let's set both values equal to 2. Let's reload the page. And this time we see 2 book items on the page. And when we click on the load more button, 2 more items are added every time. Except the last one, because there was only 1 item left to display. Now let's jump to the starting files and start coding. The book items are stored in a JSON file called books.json. I have a JavaScript file which is currently empty, and an index.html file from which we are going to start our little application. Inside the body tags, I need a content element in which I will insert the book items from the JavaScript file. The only element that I will have inside the content is the load more button. I will assign an onClick event listener on the button, which will execute a function called loadData every time the button is pressed. And last, I will link the JavaScript file with the index file. This is all the HTML we need. Now, let's jump to the JavaScript file. Before we start, I have to say that I'm not going to explain what every function does. This tutorial is more like getting directions on how to drive to your destination. I'm not going to explain how the car works. I hope it makes sense. Okay, now let's start. First thing in the file, we fetch the book items from the JSON file and we store them in the browser's local storage. Next, we access the content element and the load more button. The container variable is holding the content element and the load more button variable is holding the button element. Next, we create the initial items variable, which controls how many book items are displayed on the page. Next, we create the load items variable, which controls the number of book items are loaded when the load more button is clicked. Remember that we saw those variables in the intro section. Next, we are going to write our first function, which will display the book items when the page loads. The first thing that we do inside the function is to grab the book items from the local storage. The book variable is holding now an array of objects. Next, I'm going to initialize a variable named out to an empty string. This variable will hold the book items that we are going to display. Next, I need a counter. I'm going to use that counter to grab the number of book items that is set in the initial items variable. Next, I'm going to loop through the books array so I get access to the book items. But I have to use first an if statement to fetch the exact number of books that the initial items variable is holding, and that is 3. Inside the if statement, we are going to use the out variable and add the number of books that meet the condition. Every book item lives inside an HTML template. Next, outside the if, but still inside the for loop, we increment the counter by 1. When the loop finishes, we are going to create a div element that will wrap the books that we fetched. And we are going to insert the div element right before the load more button. And last, we are going to insert the book items in the new created div element. I hope that everything is understandable. Please leave a comment, let me know. Now let's go to the index file and set the function run from there. Let's bring the browser in the screen and run the file. Nice, so far so good. Now let's go back to the JavaScript file and write the loadData function. Let's grab again the book items from the local storage. Next, I need to know how many book items are currently displayed in the page, so we don't fetch them again. Again, I need the out variable that will hold the book items that we are going to load to the page, and the counter variable so I can get the next three items. Next, I'm going to use the forOf function to loop through the box array. And again, inside the loop, I will have an if statement, but the condition will be a lot different than the previous one. Now, the if condition goes like this. If the counter is equal or greater than the currently displayed items, and also the counter is less than the load items variable plus the currently displayed items, only then we add the book item to the out variable. In plain English, the condition skips the displayed items and adds the next set of items that the load items variable dictates, in our case, 3. And we are going to use again the HTML template and add it to the out variable. Next, we increment the counter by 1, and we are going to create again a div element to wrap the book items. Next, I will set the opacity of the div element to 0, so I can add the fade in effect. Next, I will check if there are any more items to display. I will use an if statement and I will check if the number of displayed items is equal to the items fetched from the local storage. If the condition is true, we are hiding the load more button. And last, we call the fade in function that we are going to write next to add the fade in effect to the div element. Let's write our last function. I will create a variable named opacity and I will set the value to 0. Next, I will run a setInterval function every 30 milliseconds. You can play with this number to make the effect faster or slower. Inside the setInterval function, we execute an if statement until the opacity reaches a value of 1. Every time the if statement is executed, we increase the opacity by a value of 0.1. And we add that value to the div's opacity. And when the if statement is done, inside the else clause, we stop the setInterval function by calling the clearInterval function. And that's it. Let's bring the browser in the screen to test the code. Let's reload the page. And we see our code is working fine. And here we reach the end of today's tutorial. Don't forget to jump to my website and get the source code. I hope you liked it. Thanks for watching, guys.